Nowadays, it's pretty easy to do a quick Google search for a name and find out quite a lot of info about someone. It's scary how much of my personal information is accessible, especially since I would consider myself pretty limited in the personal data I put out there. However, data brokers collect and then sell your information to scammers, spammers, advertisers, and anyone else who may want to target you. Your full name, cell phone, email, home address, health records, your relatives, it's all out there and easy to find. That's why I've started using Aura, the sponsor of today's video. Aura shows me which data brokers are selling my information and automatically submits opt-out requests for me. Cleaning up my information not only helps reduce the amount of spam I get, but protects me from hackers who could use this information to help them access my social media accounts, bank accounts, or other sensitive information. I don't know if you saw this, but AT&T recently revealed that over 73 million customer records, both existing and former customers, were released on the dark web. AT&T recommends those affected use strong passwords, monitor account activity, and consider credit freezes or fraud alerts from credit bureaus. Well, Aura does this all for me. And best of all, I don't have to download several different apps just because the company couldn't keep my data secure. To help you secure your data, Aura is offering my viewers a 14-day free trial at my special link down in the description at aura.com/FGCMS. Now back to the video and what I do best. This morning we got a 68-foot Hampton yacht, I think it is, aground out in Big Pass. So we're going to quickly run on that, and we also got another dispatch for a little 20-foot four-wind, I think it is, over by the Ringling Bridge, going back to 10th Street. But we're going to run on that grounder first, so we'll see you guys out there. Good morning.
I've been through here a lot, but I happened to be recently, and I can't believe this is shallow right here.
Yeah, you need to be about another 100, 200 feet that way.
That way?
Yeah.
God damn. My wife came saying I was too close over there.
Nope, it shifted.
Yep, it shifted.
Do you have a central cleat or two on the side?
I have two. I've got a bridle for stick out on the end.
Yeah, we can use that. He's got a nice big bridle, use that instead of the small one I've got. Make it easy. Take you guys with me. I'll grab that and tie my line on.
Do I need to unhook it?
No, I'm just looking. You It's not really set up for tying the line to it. My line's gonna get caught in that and cut.
In this hook?
Yeah.
Can't tie it to that?
Yeah, because my line's gonna pinch right inside of that. I've got a different bridle, I'll use that one. I don't know if you guys can see that. He's got a specialty bridle that's made to hook to, I don't know, probably some sort of tow line setup that he's got. But it's got a kind of metal hook on the end. And so if I tied to that, there's a good chance it would cut my line. This is definitely going to be a heavy pull. Just use my regular bridle. And how much do you draw?
About 5.
Oh, okay. Probably just gonna pull you back this way.
Okay.
And we'll probably head back that way, give us a little more room to turn around, and then you can go from there. Okay. If you want to go to channel 14. You guys happy now? I have a plan. I told them the plan. And now we're gonna be set on the radio. too much. Try getting a little bit closer to him now. Yeah, sitting out in 10 feet, so we've definitely moved. Keep making progress, then we keep hitting. And this thing's so heavy with that bit of a momentum I'm getting, it's not quite enough. Any smaller boat, as soon as we get them moving, any little bump we hit would be fine. What time did you get stuck?
Huh?
What time did you get stuck?
Oh, maybe about an hour ago when you got the call.
Okay.
Tide, low tides are flying something.
Yeah, so I'll probably run aground around 10. So I'll be back around like 2:30.
Okay, on rising tide.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah, we made some movement, but.
Yeah, I know. It kept, every now and then it kept.
Yeah,
it
get a little bump.
And all of a sudden it stopped again.
Yeah, we only need to get like another, where we are right now, we need to get about another 10 feet off your bow.
Okay.
And then you'd be in 6 foot of water. So we're not far off, but
right.
Just where your stern is a little too much.
Yeah.
So.
Seems like every time you pull down on bow, picked up
a
stern.
A little bit, yeah.
You know, whether or not we...
Oh. I've got another job to run on, but I'll be back around 2:30.
Okay.
If I'm on another job, we'll send another boat out for you. But
right.
Someone will be here around 2:30 or so.
Okay, good. Just gonna send that shamrock out.
We don't have those anymore.
Good.
So we got this one, we got a 28-foot Pro Cat, a 26-foot Mako, and a 26 Whaler Outrage.
Okay.
Yeah. We're under new ownership now, and he got rid of those the day he bought the business. Good to see that he's not facing the same direction that I left him. Means he's at least getting pretty loose up there. Or under there, depending on how you look at it. Yeah, you're looking better.
Well, it's bouncing pretty good.
Showing 6.5 here.
Okay, I'll take has noted mariners in Fort Myers, the Coral, and Clinton River, which is now 32 alpha 157 of all measures of.
Couple more reps on there. Thank you.
going to go ahead and get your engine started, and I'll stay attached to make sure everything's running good.
That's a roger.
What was that?
I should be able to limp in. I mean, they both the gear.
Okay, if you want to come and toss off the lines, we'll be good to go.
That's a wrong. You need me to sign anything?
Yeah, I just need to get a signature, but we can get that after we get situated here.
That's a roger.
Yep, you can just toss them. Heading back out, you're gonna.
I'm gonna run it, see how the props are.
Okay.
And then I may run into supper, or I may just go back to the dock right in Sarasota.
Okay.
What got to
know? I'll follow you for a little while, just to make sure everything's good.
Thank you.
I've said this before, and I'll say it again. I really love the smell of marine diesel exhaust, and the sound is awesome too. Definitely beats these outboards.